Ziel erreicht.
Hello heroes, welcome to my channel. Last Saturday I visited the Toyota Collection in Cologne for a special event. There was the premiere of the new Yaris GR, you know, the one from Gazoo Racing. This is in Cologne here. And this is presented in the Toyota Collection. The collection is built in a former tennis hall for the Toyota employees, located in the Toyota Alley here in Cologne, Germany. Yeah, as you can see, this is basically JDM heaven for Toyota fans. I will show you around a little bit. Nice mixture between old and newer cars. But let's start with the car we are here for today. Yeah, basically the Yaris GR is very hot stuff currently in the car community and quite a big surprise from Toyota. Powered by a new 1.6 liter 3-cylinder engine with 261 horsepower and 360 newton meters of torque. Yeah, the most interesting part is the new 4-wheel drive system with variable power distribution between front and rear in track mode, with 30% in the front and 70% in the rear, very rear biased. Tinted windows in the black, very nice black paint. Weighs only 2280 kilograms without driver, which is 4.9 kilograms per horse. Not bad. The fenders are very different in comparison to the standard version. As you can see, a very short wheelbase of 2560 millimeters, so pretty much the same as a GT86. Prices are not announced yet, but I would bet for just over 40,000 euros in Germany, but this is just speculation. Yeah. Could be a cool replacement for my current Yaris hybrid. I have just to convince my wife. Okay, coming to the other interesting cars in the collection. Here we have a white GT86 Cabriolet, white and blue leather interior. As you can see, it has still the useless back seats. The white paint is very nice, looks the same as you can get on some Lexus. Well, the carpets are not my taste. Color does not fit to the rest of the color scheme in my opinion. And it is an automatic version. I'm not sure if there's currently a market for this, but it is nice to see that Toyota becomes more bold and tries out some concepts. The wheels are nice, repeating the blue touch from the interior. Not sure if you can get them for the normal coupe version. And even more crazy is this Toyota IQ, the disco ball. A lot of work gluing all the glass chunks to the car. And it has even a DJ table. Behind this, a nice Toyota AE86 Treno has made quite a journey from Malaysia to Germany by a guy named Mr. Hadri. 32,000 kilometers, very impressive. Now some more down-to-earth cars. Here we have a Prius Mark IV and its brother Toyota Mirai with full cell technology. So basically it's an electric car without a big battery. It has a battery, but the main power source is hydrogen. And you actually can enter these cars here in the collection. As you can see, the interior of the cockpit is very similar to the Prius. Back to some history lessons. First Prius generation. It's interesting that it was first not planned as a hybrid car by the development team, but their boss wanted it. And a second generation cut it in pieces to show the HSD technology. It has a very roomy interior. Had one for a couple of years and replaced it with a Yaris Hybrid as a daily driver. Also a Prius 3. But back to something more sporty, a nice Celica Supra, second generation, third generation, and of course the famous fourth generation with the 2JZ engine, of course here with twin turbo. Let's go around this car a little bit. One of the last ones without any modifications. Let's take a look at the inside. It's a 4-speed automatic version. Good condition. Nice leather seats. And of course the big wing at the back, but small wheels for today's standards. Okay, and here we have a car with a connection to the Yaris GR, the Celica GT4, which is the inspiration for the four-wheel drive system of the Yaris. 4-cylinder turbo engine. All in red. And here the cabriolet version of the Celica and the standard coupe in blue. Going back in history a little bit to the Celica TA60 with its boxy 80s design. Very interesting headlamps. And the same boxy design in the inside. Very good condition with some brighter and darker materials here. Very thin steering wheel. The long stick shift. Yeah, from the same era, we have here Toyota Tercel. Here is the station wagon. You know Jesse from Breaking Bad, yeah. Little bit filthy on the roof, but you know it's a drug producer car. It's a good ground clearance, better than most today's SUVs and four-wheel drive. Speaking about SUVs, this is basically the row with SUVs and trucks here. We have a blue RAV4 and some proper Land Cruiser J7. Hardtop version. Looks pretty much like out of the factory. A G60 and G55 and of course the famous FJ40 and a BJ40 with a diesel engine and a J4 fire brigade version. And a J75 with long wheelbase and Recaro seats. And this is an engine swapped FJ40 with a Chevy V8. Very American style with wooden steering wheel and side pipes and chrome wheels. Looks more Jeep than Land Cruiser. And here we have a Toyota Model F. Very luxurious van. It looks like an old sofa from the inside. Interesting color combo. Very good condition. I bet it has not too many kilometers on its clock. Plushy seats and hard plastics everywhere. But this is typical for this era. Very spacious. It has 8 seats. Very cool Ronal turbo wheels. I don't know if they come from the factory, but they are fitting very well. Such a cool car. I don't know why, but I like it. Some smaller hatchbacks and station wagons, the Starlet and its predecessors. Here's a station wagon. Very rare car in Germany. It's small from the outside, but roomy from the inside. Here's some older ones. This is, as far as I know, the first Starlet we had here in Germany. And here, first generation as a station wagon. Very big boot for such a small car. Thin doors. And here we have some Coronas, very American inspired. As you can see, some of the cars are registered. They are all sourced from a big collection of an Austrian Toyota dealer. Another Corona. And coming to the racing department, Some JDM fans don't know, but most of the race cars from Toyota are built since the 70s here in Cologne at Toyota Motorsports. They did even some supercharger tuning kits, for example, for the MR2, including a Toyota warranty, some Corollas. All in red. And taking a look under the hood of the Mirai, looks similar to the Prius engine bay, even without any combustion engine. Toyota Sierra, with these cool doors that actually inspired McLaren for the F1, has even a trip computer for classic car rallies and, of course, right-hand drive. Cool sound system, bro. And moving to the left. Sorry, Matt Farah, this is just a 1 million kilometers Lexus, but with the first engine and transmission, of course. Good condition, even the paint is okay, and the interior could also be an interior of a 100,000 kilometer cars. Yeah, okay, it was used, but it still looks good. Part of some rust bubbles here. Okay, so time to leave. What is this? Yeah, good question, why this car needs a hook. And to close this video, some impressions of the predecessor of the GR, the GRMN, with a supercharged engine and front wheel drive, but still nice car. Okay, so thanks for watching.